We are discussing ancillary physics 3, electricity and electronics. In the last class, we have discussed about Kirchhoff laws, Kirchhoff voltage law and current law. And we have went through an example as well. In this class, we will see two more examples in order to understand clearly about the Kirchhoff laws. Among these two examples, one example is from Wheatstone Bridge. After understanding this problem using Wheatstone bridge, let us generalize this Wheatstone bridge with Kirchhoff's laws. Using that, we can find a way to identify the unknown resistance using Wheatstone bridge. So first, let's see two examples. First example, you can write the question now. Two cells of EMF 1.5 volt and 2.2 volt and 2 volt, not 2.2 volt, 2 volts respectively and of internal resistance one ohm and 2 ohms respectively or connected in parallel with an external resistance. Of 5 ohms. Calculate the current in each branch of the network. What is the question? Two cells of EMF 1.5 volt and 2 volts respectively and of internal resistance 1 ohm and 2 ohms respectively are connected in parallel with an external resistance of 5 ohms. Calculate the current in each branch of the network. If you read simply the problem, you won't be able to understand. You need to sketch the diagram out of it. So first, there are two cells of EMF 1.5 volt and 2 volt whose internal resistance are 1 ohm, 2 ohm. There are two cells connected parallel. So let's draw two cells which are connected parallel. One is E1, another one is E2. First has the value 1.5 volt, second has the value 2 volt, and internal resistance first has 1 ohm, second has 2 ohm. Now an external resistance 5 ohms . Okay, so there is an external resistance in this. This network is connected to an external resistance which has the value 5 ohms. This alone is given, and this is the problem which is similar to the one which we have discussed in the previous lecture. So now at this node you can apply Kirchhoff current law. At this node, for the entire circuit you can apply Kirchhoff voltage law. For that purpose, let us define this A and this is R, this node is B, and this is E1, this is E2. So at this node, you can define the current flowing through the battery. One is I1, then current flowing the going through the battery is battery 2 is I2. This is E2. Now applying Kirchhoff current law at node A, KCL at A, that gives the algebraic sum of the currents at a particular point is equal to 0 in a circuit when the steady state current is flowing. In that case, I1 plus I2, which is equal to I. So this side you can put I. Okay, so I is equal to I1 plus I2. And second, you can apply KCL for the loop A or B E1 A. In that case, it is I1 plus I2 times R, which is 5 ohms, plus current through this loop. What is that? I into R. We don't know what is I, so it is I1 and R is 1 ohm. So you have to multiply 1, which is equal to 1.5. This is equation number 1. You can rewrite this as 5I1 plus 5I2 plus I1, which is equal to 1.5, so that 6I1 plus 5I2, which is equal to 1.5. This is equation number 1. And again, you can write Kirchhoff, not current law, it is voltage law. Kirchhoff voltage law for the second loop, that is through the battery E2. So from point A to R, then to B, then to E2, then A. In this case, we can write again voltage at the battery is I1 plus I2 into R5 plus, here it is 2 into I2. So 2 times I2, which is equal to 2. Now this becomes 5I1 plus 5I2 plus 2I2, which is equal to 2. So that 5I1 plus 7I2, which is equal to 2. This is equation number 2. Now solving these two equations, how to solve? I can rewrite this equation for I2. Right? So 7I2, which is equal to 2 minus 5I1. So I2 equal to 2 minus 5I1 divided by 7. This is equation number 3. Now substitute this equation number 3 into equation number 1. 6 times I1 plus 5 times 2 minus 5I1 divided by 7, which is equal to 1.5. And what you can do, you can multiply the entire equation with 7, so that 42I1 plus, so 10 minus 25I1, which is equal to, you have to multiply this with 7. So 1.5 multiplied by 7. If you solve this equation for I1, then you will get the value for I1 as 0.0249 ampere. Then substituting this value I1 into this equation here, I2 equal to 2 minus 5 I1 by 7. Substitute this I1 here, you will get I2. So in this way you can get I2. You can substitute, work out and find the value 0.2647 ampere. So if you are asked to calculate the current in an each branch of the network, right? So this is the current through the battery 1 and this is the current through battery 2. Next, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the current through the resistance. What is the current through the resistance? In this, you know, this current is flowing through this direction. Hope you remember. What is the current through the resistance? Current through the battery E1 and current through the battery E2. Now we have to calculate the current through the resistance. That is nothing but the sum of the current through these batteries. So simply you can write I, which is equal to I1 plus I2. You can sum these two and you can write. So 0.0249 ampere and 0.2647 ampere. 6982. 0.2896 ampere is the current which is flowing through the resistor. Another example related to Wheatstone bridge. Second problem, the resistances of the 4 ohms of a Wheatstone's network are 5, 5, 5, 1, 5.2 ohms. The resistance of the galvanometer is 40 ohms and the battery supplies a current of 0.2 amp. Then calculate the current through the galvanometer. So what is Wheatstone bridge? Wheatstone bridge consisting of four resistors. Okay, and a galvanometer is connected in the middle. This is its own bridge. So it has 4 arms, 1, 2, 3, 4 arms, and each has 5 ohms, 5 ohms, and here also 5 ohms, and this is 5.2 ohms. And you can denote this is A, this is B, and this node, and this node is C, and this node is D. Okay, and these 4 ohms has 5, 5, and 5.2 ohms. The resistance of the galvanometer is 40 ohms. And the battery supplies a current of, and it has a battery connected to that. This is Wheatstone bridge, and battery you can say E, and it supplies the current in this direction. You can say I, that is equal to 0.2 amp. Now let's say this is 0.2 ohm, I we can use it here. So the current flowing through this direction here, 0.2 ampere current is coming inwards, and it is dividing into two lines. I current is flowing through this resistor, while 0.2 minus I, according to Kirchhoff current law, the current coming into the node is equal to the current leaving from that node. So the current I is leaving from this node. 2.2 ampere is coming to this node. So from 0.2 ampere, I ampere current is flowing through this node, so that 0.2 minus I ampere will flow this node. Okay. Then here it is I current coming towards point B, and there are some current, this I divided into 2, right, and some currents are flowing into that, and that current, that is the current flowing through galvanometer, we can denote IG, and here the incoming current is IG, and here incoming current is 0.2 minus I, which is equal to this point. That current, which is equal to current flow leaving from the point D, is 0.2 minus I plus IG. Okay, and here we define that IG is the current which is passing through the galvanometer, I is the current coming into the point B, so that the current flowing through this resistor is I minus IG. Let me repeat, Wheatstone bridge consisting of the four resistors which are having the value 5 ohms, 5 ohms, 5 ohms and 5.2 ohms as given in 5 ohms, 5 ohms, 5 ohms and 5.2 ohms. And resistance through the calorimeter is 40 ohm. And then a battery, here is a battery that supplies the current of 0.2 ampere. Now this current is flowing in this loop, but in this loop, see, it is starting this point and it is going here. At the node A, it is divided into two branches, and the first branch goes to the point B through the resistance 5 ohms. At point B, it is divided into two branches again, and one is going through the galvanometer, other is going through the 5 ohms resistor. And now here the second branch and the branch from the galvanometer joins at point D, and it's going towards C. Then here a branch coming from point B also coming, and both are joining at C, and it's flowing downwards and to reach the point where we have started. So this is the flow chart for the current. Now we are applying Kirchhoff's current law at node A, node B, node D. Okay, so at node A, what is that? Here 0.2 amperes of current which is incoming to the point A, that is divided into two. One we denote I current. I is the current that is flowing from A to B, while the remaining, that is 0.2 minus I, which is flowing from A to D. So out of the current I at point B, it is divided into two, so that Ig is the amount of current that is flowing through the galvanometer. So that I minus Ig is the current that is flowing through BC line. And at the point D, there are two currents which are coming to this node. One is A to D, another one is B to D. B to D is nothing but Ig, A to D is nothing but 0.2 minus I. Both are have to algebraically summed, 0.2 minus I plus Ig, that is equal to the leaving current. That is equal to the leaving current. So that current, this flowing, this will be equal to the current coming through this, coming to this point D. So this is the idea. Now, how to solve this? First, we have to apply Kirchhoff's law, Kirchhoff's voltage law for the loop A, B, D, A. For the loop A, B, D, A. What is that? A, B, what is the voltage? 5 ohms into current I plus B, D, it is 40 ohms into I, G. Then D, A. Okay? AB, BD, then if you calculate in this direction, if you close this, then you have to put minus. So you can put minus, it consisting of 5 ohms, 0.2 minus I. Why it is minus? Because the direction of the flow of current is going towards A to D, but the loop is closing like this, loop going opposite side. So that we have to put minus. So that is equal to 0. Which means 5i plus 40ig minus 1 plus I, which is equal to 0. So that 6i plus 40ig, which is equal to 1. This is equation 1. And then we can apply Kirchhoff's voltage law for this point B, D, C, B. B, D, C, B. So voltage between B and D is 40 Ig plus voltage between D and C is nothing but 5.2 times 0.2 minus I plus IG. Then if we draw this loop we can draw like this. Okay. And if we draw like this, then from C to B it is minus. So minus 5 ohms resistor and the current is I minus IG. I minus IG which is equal to 0. So now we can write, rewrite this equation, 40 IG plus 5.2 into 0.2. So 5.2 into 0.2, 1.04 minus 5i plus 5.2i plus 5.2ig minus 5i plus 5ig is equal to 0. So that 40ig plus 1.04. So 5.2i minus 5i minus 10.2i plus 10.2ig which is equal to 0. So that 50.2ig minus 10.2i which is equal to minus 1.04, and this is equation number 2. Here equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now we can rewrite this equation for I. We can write this equation for I. So 6i which is equal to 1 minus 40 IG, I equal to 1 by 6 into 1 minus 40 IG. You substitute this I here, so that 50.2 IG minus 10.2 by 6, 1 minus 40 IG is equal to minus 0.4. So this equation becomes IG in terms of IG. If you solve IG, you will get IG which is equal to minus 0.000198 ampere. Do the arithmetic calculation and check whether this answer is right or wrong. Okay. So in this way we can calculate the current flowing through the galvanometer. Right? So this is, the parameters are given. So we have deduced what is what. Now apply these concepts, that is the Kirchhoff's voltage law and current law, using Wheatstone bridge, and find an equation to calculate the unknown resistance. Suppose if these resistance are unknown, we have to find the equation to estimate the unknown resistances using this concept. That is what the next topic that we are going to discuss. That topic in the next lecture. Thank you.